It's currently 6:06 p.m. right now. The Eminem album drops in less than 3 hours. But yeah, the song Houdini, I want to see a lot of songs like that where it's like a mix of Slim Shady and Eminem. I also want the album to be kind of like Relapse, where when you listen top to bottom, it makes more sense. So yeah, those are my final thoughts before I listen to this album in 2 hours and 50 minutes.
3 hours later.
Eminem just dropped The Death of Slim Shady, and it was pretty crazy. I've only listened to it about 1.5 times, but this is gonna be my first thoughts on it. Before this video even starts though, I do not want you to watch this unless you've heard the album. This is gonna have spoilers. So yeah, thank you for clicking on the video, but if you haven't listened, make sure to click off the video now and maybe come back later, because your first experience to this album is gonna be pretty interesting. Overall, it was exactly what we asked for as fans. It was the new Eminem, old Eminem, and everything in between. He added it all into one album, and it sounded pretty good overall. I do have a couple nitpicks, we'll get into those, but honestly, top to bottom, this whole story is amazing. As far as I heard, you can kind of break it into sections. The beginning was Eminem being offensive, I guess. He was offensive throughout the whole track list, but very prominent in the beginning. He was dissing basically everyone with a big name and trying to get canceled, and that starts with Renaissance. It's the first track. It has like a Relapse voice, Relapse beat, more like background music, I guess, and just that raw Eminem voice. It reminded me of Rock Bottom. Sounded very dark, but it was a great intro to this album. Reminded me a lot of like 3 a.m. and like the Tanya skit from Relapse, kind of fused into one. That transitioned into the song Habits, which is a pretty simple beat, but I love the transition from the first track to the second track. That simple beat was pretty catchy though, and I love the way that Eminem was flowing on it. However, this is where the first issue for me kind of came up. It was with that AI Eminem voice. Now, obviously, Eminem wanted the Slim Shady sound. He wanted the voice, I guess, and he can't remake that voice now. So what he did was he used AI, at least I'm guessing this. I've only listened to this once, so this is kind of just me guessing and rambling, but it sounded very robotic. It sounded like he was trying to sound like Slim Shady. It sounded like a computer was trying to do it. And that kind of makes sense. If you guys know how AI works and how training data works, it's trained over old Slim Shady sounds, so maybe like old songs. But then you have like the beat in the background and it's just like compressed and everything. But this kind of kept with that theme of being toxic, trying to get canceled again. And so did the next song. Trouble was even more prominent. It was Eminem dissing everyone, basically. And once again, Slim Shady in the Slim Shady voice. It sounded like Slim Shady was mocking the idea of being canceled again, which I wasn't opposed to. I liked the way that this song was executed. This is so funny because I listened to this album like once or twice, and I wrote some notes for a couple of the songs, but I don't have them like memorized in my head. So forgive me if I'm kind of like mixing this up. Let me know if I should make like a 1 month later video or 3 months later when I really have the songs like cemented in my head. But yeah, like I said, in the beginning, he's trying to get canceled. Brand New Dance was one of my favorites. It sounded a lot like Encore. People in my Discord were saying it sounded like AI. I don't think so. I think it was an unreleased Encore song. It sounded way too good, way too genuine. He put the old Encore song with new Eminem vocals, kind of like the song Jimmy, Brian, and Mike, if you guys know what that is. It's from the Eminem Show Expanded Edition. And yeah, I love the way he fused those together. I wrote outro was good. I don't know. I like the outro to the song, I guess. I just listened back. I got caught up. It's the old like Eminem Encore phone call prank thing. And yeah, that did sound pretty good. It sounded a lot like the Encore version. Some of this stuff makes me feel like you recorded it back then and put it on it now. But other times, like I said earlier, you can really hear that AI and it doesn't sound too good when you can tell that it's the robotic AI. It's the same thing with Evil. Evil had kind of an interesting beginning. I wasn't sure how I liked it, but as it went further, I started to like it more. But once again, you can hear the AI voice. When it sounds good, it sounds really good. But when you can hear the AI glitching, it ruins the whole song for me, honestly. I think he probably could have got away with it if he put more reverb on it, but it was just very harsh and very prominent when the AI did mess up. But I can't complain about it too much because I think it was better than him trying to like remake the sound and it not sounding like Slim Shady. So if you can look past the robotic little glitches that you can kind of hear, then you'll probably like the AI Slim Shady voice. So far in the song, I was talking about how I like the skits, the transitions, the full theme. It's got that whole story like I talked about leading into the song Lucifer, which had a lot of old references. It said, make like Bonnie and Clyde. Then you hear a crash sound effect, obviously a reference to the old Slim Shady LP song. And yeah, I mean, all throughout the album, you can hear references, wordplay, sound effects from all of his old music, and I love that. With Eminem's album being rolled out as we speak, there's a good chance he's gonna go on tour. And if not him, there's plenty of artists that will. So if you wanna go to any concert or sports game, maybe a football game, you've probably seen how expensive the tickets are. That's where SeatGeek comes in. When you go to buy the ticket, it gives you a scale 0 to 10 on how good the ticket is for the value that you're buying it for. And it's the easiest website and app that I've used to buy tickets. And also, because of the partnership with the channel, if you use my code ITSMASON at checkout, you get $20 off. So maybe you want to go to a concert and it's $60, you can use the code and you'll get in there for $40. So yeah, definitely worth it to use SeatGeek if you're buying tickets, and thank you to them for sponsoring this video. The next song was called Antichrist, which honestly goes along with the theme, because remember, Slim Shady's trying to get canceled, so Lucifer and then Antichrist back to back. He's trying to get canceled, but it's kind of like a bipolar song, I guess. It goes back and forth from different voices, different flows. It really holds that Slim Shady type beat. I don't really know how to explain it. It's got that old, like, old beats that you hear from Eminem, he really has that on this track. And the hook sounded like the Eminem Show. I'd compare it to maybe like Business from the Eminem Show, at least the vocal tone on the hook. Then the beat switches into like a beat with Bizarre, a little more eerie, I guess you could say. All I'm gonna say is if you like Bizarre's music, you'll like it. If not, you won't like it because it's Bizarre at the end of the day. Then the song Fuel, which honestly is my favorite song off this album as of now. I've wanted Jid on this album for months. I've been talking about that. I love Jid. I think Jid is a very underrated rapper. You can hear it from the very start of the track to the end of his verse. He's spitting. It reminded me of the Homicide song with Logic. I hope I can say that word on YouTube, but remember Logic was like spitting like crazy. He was doing really good, and then Eminem came out and like blew him out of the water. It was kind of the similar way. Same way in the fact that Eminem had probably a better verse, but I think Jid was better than Logic overall. Once again, the song had AI, but I think it was executed much better on here. Road Rage had kind of a goofy beat. He talked about some important things, some things he was just trolling about. Remember, he's trying to get canceled at the end of the day, so he's doing a little bit of both. Something that stood out to me was the stereo effect in his voice. If you wear headphones, you can kind of hear it like pan to both sides. That was very prominent on the song. And yeah, I love the whole vocal chain throughout the whole song. We've all heard Houdini. I did a live stream about it. I love the music video, love the song. I think it was great. Honestly, didn't really fit in on the album though. Before you go to the comments, because I know that sounds crazy, a lot of the songs have the same like dark, eerie beat to them, but Houdini's just out of nowhere. Like, abra. Like the whole hook is just different. I like Houdini. I love Houdini. But it might have been the songs around it, something. It just didn't really fit in at that part of the album, I guess. But yeah, Houdini, great song. The breaking news skit is basically people boycotting Eminem, and then it transitions into Guilty Conscience 2. Now, Guilty Conscience 2 is very interesting because when we saw that on the track list, everyone was talking about how they want Dr. Dre. You'd expect Dr. Dre, but we didn't really get that. It was more of Eminem versus the AI Eminem, or I guess Slim Shady, kind of beefing with each other, going back and forth. It reminded me of the song My Darling, kind of, where it's like good versus evil, beefing with each other. Slim Shady talks about his old beefs. Eminem has a dream. I think it was a dream where he goes and kills Slim Shady. A couple little complaints aside, I love the track, but it wasn't really Guilty Conscience Part 2. It was more of like Eminem versus Slim Shady. I think that would have been a better title. Definitely a good addition to Eminem's catalog though. I like the whole like idea of the song. Head Honcho was a good lyrical performance. I saw people complaining about the feature in the beginning. I thought it was fine. I didn't think it was bad at all. Another Eminem on a creepy beat that sounded very similar, holding his rhyme schemes very well. Temporary was kind of like nostalgia filled, very emotional, very different from the rest of the album. Mostly it was very emotional. It had Skylar Grey. I think it was meant for his daughter. He mixed old audio clips from like home videos, I think some old music, made a very emotional song, maybe a Mockingbird or When I'm Gone Part 2. Bad One was a bass heavy instrumental. Pretty simple beat, but it's Eminem, so it's advanced lyrics. If you like the new Eminem, you'll like this. It's kind of like Music to be Murdered By, I guess. Toby, we kind of talked about Toby in the last video, but honestly, I think Babytron could have done better. Big Sean had a great verse. Eminem had a great verse. We know Babytron can rap. If you've listened to Babytron over the last couple years, you know he could keep up with those guys, but he didn't. I know he had the hook, so he wasn't, and he had the intro too, so he wasn't really like as hyped up as the others, but I think Babytron could have done better. If we're looking at just the singles, Houdini and Toby, I definitely prefer Houdini, but that's also because it's Eminem without features. I prefer Eminem without features. But then the Guess Who's Back skit, even though it doesn't say it in the title, this is another Ken Keneff skit, so if you like Ken Keneff, you'll like this. It's got a lot of reverb on it. If you don't like Ken Keneff, you won't like this one either. And it's kind of interesting because you go from Ken Keneff to Somebody Save Me. Somebody Save Me reminds me of Headlights by Eminem. It's kind of emotional. It sounds like the point of view of if Eminem died from his overdose. Once again, dedicated to his daughter, and I think it was a very good closeout to the album. I mean, if this is Eminem's last album, which we'll probably talk about in a future video, I think this is a good way to end it with this song. But once again, that's kind of where the inconsistency that I complained about comes back in. Temporary, like I said, was Mockingbird Part 2. So you go from that to a Music to be Murdered By type song, to Toby, to a Ken Keneff skit, so like a goofy, weird skit, and then right back to Somebody Save Me, talking about his overdose. Kind of inconsistent with like the mood that you're supposed to be in while listening to this album. But overall, I love it. I was hoping for more Slim Shady type songs. He used the AI. I didn't like every part of the AI, but I think he did pretty good overall with it. He did a good job at trying to get himself canceled. He said some pretty crazy things in the beginning. And yeah, that's my thoughts on The Death of Slim Shady. Once again, first or second time listening through it. Haven't really memorized the songs much, but if you guys want to see me do an update video on it later, let me know down below. By the time this is up, you guys have probably heard it a couple times, so let me know your thoughts on it. I want to see them down below. I'll be reading all the comments. Thank you guys for watching. If you want more Eminem videos, click right up here. We got tons of them. I think there's like almost 40 now. And yeah, if you want more videos like this, subscribe, give it a thumbs up if you like it. Thumbs down if you don't. Thanks for watching. Peace out.